Hey everyone, Sean Clement here, and boy oh boy, we have an amazing treat for you today. You saw the video I just put out with Cameron Champ, and another person came on the scene over the weekend, is attracting a lot of attention. It's actually one of George Gankus's students by the name of Matthew Wolf, and he put on quite a show for his team this weekend. And you look at the similarities between himself and Cameron Champ in the backswing, and that's what I put together for you guys today. Let's have a look. Okay, so you can see right here, they're talking about the latest sensation in Oklahoma, Matt Wolf, and you look at backswing. So obviously he's got a timing mechanism. You can see how he nudges forward. And then let's have a look at that. So you notice at the top of the backswing, just how much that lead knee has rotated in, and how much that left heel is off the ground, and how his whole backside is turned to the target. And you can see a huge rotation of that right femur. See where his butt is going? And now look at how much his head is rotated as well. So now he is very much poised to go grab the ground. So he's going to the target, of course, because that's what he never thinks about, his swing. Now we're going to the target. So look at that gorgeous squat. Gets the ground, and look at the amount of lag coming through there. See where his head is? His head's still back because he's going toward the target. That's when you can always tell if somebody is still thinking about their target. And then you notice where that finish is headed to. So very, very much along the same lines as Cameron Champ. Okay, so you notice we're talking about completing the backswing. Got some fantastic videos on that. Complete the backswing, Sean Clement. How to complete the backswing. Lower body in the backswing, Sean Clement. Check that out. We talk about the anatomy of the human being and how it's designed to allow you to gather a full backswing, just like a baseball pitcher. So if you look at a Matt Wolf, you really see the baseball motion in his backswing. Same thing with Cameron Champ. You look at how his head is allowed to move, and you look at how the pelvis and the rib cage are gathering out of the way so he can create some amazing width. We just talked about that in the last video. So as you're performing that turn, and Sean's been talking about, and that happened also in a beautiful show he did with Kevin Chappell. And he's working with Kevin right now, trying to allow him to turn his head more in the backswing and allowing him to rotate the femurs. Well, half your knee is the femur. The femur is also your hip. Now, your legs are the movers of the rib cage and the pelvis. They sit on top of the hips. And they have beautiful facet joints that prevent the rib cage and the pelvis from falling out of whack. You don't want to, you know, walk around like Quasimodo. So these facet joints have less than 1 degree of range of motion between them. So if you look at my video entitled Lower Body in the Backswing, I show you with my life-size skeleton how that works in the backswing. So the lower body was not meant to separate from the upper body, especially not in the backswing. That will happen in the downswing with the engagement of the kinetic chain. So the kinetic chain is, well, we've lived with this self-preserving system for millions of years. We threw a lot of stuff at our food for a very long period of time. That's why, you know, playing baseball and hockey and tennis and golf are all activities that we love to do because we're built to do these things. So I get into my position, you notice my feet are going to be a little more open. Why? For most people, the vast majority of people, the pelvis has the ball sockets of the hips plugged in from slightly behind. So notice how my feet, if I let my leg hang from my hip joint, my foot opens up. And this allows me to get out of the way in the backswing. If I needed to snap a punch in the backswing with my left arm, well, my brain would go get the ground, use the ground to get my body out of the way, and I would have access to my opponent. Same thing if I want to go in this direction. So I need to gather my backswing, and now I'm in a great position of width. So if you look at both Matt and Cameron, so huge turn in the backswing, and then you look at Matt on the downswing, he's got this huge, you know, downloading, down cocking of the wrists. So his big turn, he comes across the line, and then when he loads and cocks down, you'll notice, so across the line, when he cocks down, see what happens? So just like a baseball pitcher gets wide with the elbow, and then the elbow, after it engages in that kinetic chain, the elbow follows suit in that kinetic chain. So the key is to have plenty of width to give the elbow the space to lead. And that's what you're going to see amazingly well in Cameron Champ. Beautiful pocket of space here in front of the body that allows him to go deep to the target. You're going to see these two guys taking it deep that way, not toward the ball. So you don't want to be in a position that's going to lock out that elbow. You want that elbow to be very much part of that kinetic chain. As soon as, so imagine if you had a sword in your hands. So if you look at our beautiful slash video, right? Get that club speed. If I had a sword in my hands and I wanted to slash through a sugar cane, notice where my elbow is. If my elbow is tucked to my side, then I'd be slashing into myself. Everything is out here in beautiful position. So notice the elbow leads, then the hand, then the blade, then the tip of the blade, and the peak speed is out here. So I get into my position, gather the backswing, deliver through the ball and toward the target. And so for an easy 7-iron, we're looking at about 180 yards.